challenge you. I challenge you. I ask you to go out and play well. I challenge you to make some big plays, to go out and have fun and perform. But I challenge you to go out and play well.
Last day of the rest of my life. I wish you would have known, because I didn't kiss my mama goodbye. I didn't tell her that I loved her, how much I cared. I bet my pops were all the talks and all the wisdom.
The 2001 football season marked the beginning of another chapter for the storied Georgetown football program, as the Hoyas became a new member of the highly regarded Patriot League. The Hoyas were led by eighth-year head coach Bob Benson, along with captains Brian Blankenship, Aaron Brown, Scott Pogorelick, and a senior class who helped record 26 wins in their 4 years on the Hilltop. The Hoyas opened the season against the 10th-ranked and defending Patriot League champion Lehigh Mountain Hawks and performed admirably. Quarterback Sean Peterson threw touchdown passes to sophomore Luke McArdle and freshman Craig Agnello to complete the Hoyas' scoring. Agnello was named Patriot League Rookie of the Week for his play. Although the Hoyas came up short, their effort would become a constant throughout the season, and they would never give up. This would become evident in the Hoyas' dramatic wins over Duquesne, Davidson, and San Diego. Against Duquesne, the Georgetown defense shut down the potent Dukes, while the offense moved the ball and controlled the clock. But it came down to special teams heroics, as Duquesne scored a touchdown to tie the game at 13 with 3 minutes remaining. The extra point would give Duquesne the lead, but senior Scott Pogorelick blocked the point after, and freshman Byron Anderson raced 82 yards for the two-point conversion, giving the Hoyas a 15-13 win. For his efforts, Anderson, a Montgomery Village, Maryland native, received Patriot League Rookie of the Week honors. The following week saw Georgetown at home against Davidson, and special teams again proved to be the difference. Second-year law student Mark Samuel kicked 4 field goals in the victory, including what proved to be the game winner from 41 yards out. In the first half, punter David Paulus, a junior out of Syracuse, New York, took the snap from center and ran 53 yards for a touchdown. Freshman wide receiver Kurt Bennett scored on a 65-yard touchdown pass from Sean Peterson to close out the scoring. For his efforts, Bennett was selected as Patriot League Rookie of the Week. The Georgetown victory was sealed when senior defensive end Eric Spiron intercepted a 2-point conversion pass with 52 seconds left, earning the Hoyas a 26-24 victory. The Hoyas headed to the West Coast on the first Saturday in November to play the University of San Diego. The Hoyas dominated the first half of play on their way to a 17-7 halftime lead. A 17-yard touchdown pass from Sean Peterson to Trenton Hillier, along with an 18-yard touchdown run by freshman John Sims and a Mark Samuel field goal, provided the points. Sophomore Calvin Lyons from Dallas, Texas, blocked a punt in the first half, what would be a sign of things to come. A late San Diego touchdown gave the Toreros a 21-17 lead with time running out. The Hoyas never gave up. Junior Jamar Staples, a Roanoke, Virginia native, blocked a San Diego punt, the second of the night, and Peterson hit Hillier for a touchdown with 3 seconds left to give the Hoyas a 24-21 victory. Freshman defensive lineman Andy McCoy out of Hookstown, Pennsylvania, was the fourth Georgetown freshman to be named Patriot League Rookie of the Week. Throughout the season on offense, senior quarterback Sean Peterson led the Hoyas. Peterson completed 189 passes for 2,004 yards, along with 12 touchdown strikes. Peterson, who completed over 60% of his passes, became the 7th highest passer in Georgetown history. His 18.9 completions per game placed him 18th in the nation in NCAA 1AA. His 189 completions were the second highest single season total in Georgetown history, and his completion percentage placed him second in the Patriot League. A talented group of receivers combined to catch 129 passes for 1,531 yards. The core of receivers were led by sophomore Luke McCardle, who caught 41 passes for 511 yards, and junior Trenton Hillier, who caught 37 passes for 395 yards. Sophomores Walter Bowser and Andy Fleming, along with freshmen Kurt Bennett and Craig Agnello, were added weapons to the Hoyas passing attack. Senior Bo Cote, sophomore Jack Coons, and freshman Ryan Franken, who combined for 23 receptions for 157 yards, handled the tight end position and performed well. The offensive line duties were handled by juniors Adam Reaney and Ed Kuzma, senior Brett Bielfus, sophomore Ty Hollister, and freshman Frank Tirizzino and Ryan Goffles. The running back duties were handled by senior Aaron Brown, sophomore Dewan Dix, freshman John Sims, junior Jamar Staples, and sophomore Bill Husking. This unit of backs were threats both rushing and receiving in the Hoya offense. Defensively, the Hoyas were led up front by senior Scott Pogorelick, Brian Blankenship, and Josh Thomas, along with junior Justin Haynes and freshman Andy McCoy. Pogorelick led this group with 37 tackles. Senior Eric Spiron, junior Mike Schramma, and sophomore Ken Osher were solid at the defensive end position. Spiron, out of Chicago, led the team in tackles for loss. The linebacker duties fell on the shoulders of seniors Matt Craffey and Ryan Merce, junior Nick Schultz, and sophomores William Scoltetti and Andrew Clark. Together, this group combined for 193 tackles. Craffey and Schultz finished the season as the Hoyas' second and third leading tacklers, respectively. The secondary was led by sophomore Matt Fronsky, seniors Ryan Cooper, Keith Tornicchia, and Keith Marshall, as well as sophomore Dan Doherty and freshman Mark Clark, Daryl Collier, and Byron Anderson. Fronsky led the team in tackles with 74, and his four interceptions also led the team, ranking him fourth in the Patriot League. Ryan Cooper, out of Newport Beach, California, finished the season as the fourth leading tackler and tied for third in interceptions. Tornicchia, a product of Franklin Lakes, New Jersey, and Marshall out of Capitol Heights, Maryland, were also major contributors on special teams. Byron Anderson's three interceptions placed him second on the Hoya defense. The special teams were an integral part of the Georgetown game plan week in and week out. Senior Mark Samuel handled the kicking duties and was perfect, leading the Patriot League in point after attempt conversions. Senior Ryan Fugit handled the deep snapping responsibilities, as David Paulus continued to be solid as the punter. Paulus also showed his versatility by returning 11 kickoffs for 230 yards. Luke McCardle led the team in both kickoff returns and punt returns, combining for 744 yards. McCardle, a Boxford, Massachusetts native, was also the team leader in all-purpose yards, averaging 126 yards per game, ranking him sixth in the Patriot League.
Number one, no matter if you like it or take it.
The 2001 Hoyas faced tremendous challenges in their inaugural Patriot League season and helped lay the foundation for the ultimate goal of a Patriot League championship and an automatic berth in the NCAA-1AA National Championship playoffs. With a core of returning veterans and new talent, along with a sense of purpose, the Hoyas are on track to becoming a force in the Patriot League.
Win on three, one, two, three.